This is a short lesson about RF engineering. We are explaining the equivalent circuit diagram for a DIY loop antenna. It helps us for both the understanding and the tuning. Actually, I wanted to show the tuning directly. But to be honest, it wasn't easy for me to tune this antenna either. I realized that I had to find a certain procedure instead of just fiddling with the antenna until it worked. You could tune the antenna that way, but it's always better to understand what you're doing. I have thought a lot about this, and I think the findings are worth sharing with you. We can explain the working principle of this antenna, and I have provided evidence for this by simulations and measurements. We are actually exciting two resonance modes on this loop antenna. Similar to other antenna types, we vary the geometry a little in order to tune the antenna precisely to a desired center frequency. As always when tuning, everything seems to depend on everything. So we need to better understand what's actually going on when varying different parts of the geometry. Today we are really getting into high frequency engineering when creating an equivalent circuit diagram. And in a coming video I will show the tuning procedure of the antenna. As explained in previous videos, we integrated a quarter wavelength transformer into the antenna for the impedance matching. It's that thing here. We represent that part as a transformer in our equivalent circuit diagram. It transforms the 50 ohms impedance of our coaxial cable into a higher impedance to feed our loop. Okay, but how does the signal get onto the loop? The end of the transformer is actually open. The answer is, the electric field is coupling to the loop. This is what we call a capacitive coupling, which I draw as a serial capacity into our equivalent circuit. And then we have the loop itself, which we represent by a LC resonant circuit that has our desired resonant frequency. And then we have the impedance of free space, which is about 377 ohms. Just as a side note, the impedance of free space is a nature constant that can be derived from the square root of the electric field constant divided by the magnetic field constant. In principle, an antenna is just a matching device which transforms the impedance of our coaxial cable to the impedance of free space. This is how you can represent the radiation of an RF signal into free space as an equivalent circuit. First, a horizontal resonance is excited on the loop. The radiation characteristics is corresponding approximately to that of an antenna, which consists of two stacked half-wave dipoles. By the way, this is where my original expectations went. As we know today, there is still an additional effect. This is because a second vertical resonance also can be excited on the loop. And that actually happens because the small asymmetry caused by this arrangement here stimulates the vertical resonance. I have shown this through simulations and measurements in previous videos. Considering that effect, our equivalent circuit looks like this. Now it is the equivalent for two coupled antennas, each with a band filter connected. The two orthogonal resonance modes are radiating a horizontally polarized, a vertically polarized wave, as well as circularly polarized waves. Cool, right? And as you know, that's the secret why the antenna works better than expected. You can't tell by looking at it the first time, but I hope my explanations help the understanding. In any case, I recommend my previous videos on loop antennas. Now let's briefly consider what is actually important if the antenna is to function properly. It is obvious that we have to tune the resonance frequency of the two resonance circuits to our center frequency. Next, there is the quarter wavelength transformer that we need to tune. Here we actually need to do two things. We first have to adjust its length to exactly a quarter of the wavelength, so that the transformer transforms the non-reactive impedance of our coaxial cable into a higher non-reactive impedance. We're talking about approximately 500 ohms, into which we transform the 50 ohms from the cable. The connection point of our coax cable is defined by the angle alpha, which we calculated before using our Excel tool. You will find that tool also on the channel. We can optimize the transformation ratio by slightly varying the connection point of our coaxial cable. I think the equivalent circuit made it clear that we have to take several effects into account when tuning the antenna. And for that we need a good strategy and some kind of procedure that we can follow. If we tuned everything correctly in the end, we actually get an interesting antenna, as we have seen already from several measurements. It's really not easy to understand how such an antenna works when you have it in your hands. A layman would probably say, I only see two short circuits here, caused by a longer and a shorter wire. High frequency engineering can be very interesting. I hope you were able to take something away from my video. By the way, it is possible to make a small donation via my PayPal link to finance the channel. In a coming video, I would like to explain the actual tuning. And we will see whether the realization as a planar structure can be advantageous for this antenna. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.